Hello all everyone, so welcome back to Dr. Ankit Pharmacology series. So now we will be discussing about the rapid MCQ revision series of central nervous system part 2. Now in this part we will be discussing about anti-epileptic drugs or epilepsy, and we will also be discussing about neurodegenerative disease like Parkinson's disease, Wilson's disease, Alzheimer's disease, Huntington's disease, etc. Okay. So let's start with the first topic, of indeed a very important topic, that is epilepsy and anti-epileptic drugs. Okay, so let's first have a basic idea of what is epilepsy. Now remember, there is a difference between three words: seizure, convulsions and epilepsy. Now seizure means any abnormal neuronal discharge in a brain. If a neuron becomes depolarized suddenly, abnormally, it will fire up. This is known as seizure. And if this neuron is a motor neuron, it will lead to convulsions, it will lead to body movement. Body movement due to seizures are known as convulsions. So remember, if there is a neuron which is a sensory neuron, that seizure will not lead to convulsions. The classical example we will discuss is absence seizure. Now remember, one episode of seizure does not require any treatment. What required treatment is epilepsy. Epilepsy means recurrent seizures. Okay. So if you talk about the treatment of epilepsy, the treatment goals are two. If a person comes to you with acute attack, we will treat that, and we have to prevent the further recurrent attacks of epilepsy. Now remember, if a patient comes to you with acute attack, generally we don't give any drug. We give a drug only after 5 minutes. Okay. So the acute attack of seizure, which requires drug treatment, is known as status epilepticus. So what is the definition of status epilepticus? It is the acute attack of seizure which required drugs treatment, and we generally start the treatment after 5 minutes. Now the drug of choice for status epilepticus, remember, is benzodiazepine, and among benzodiazepines it is intravenous lorazepam, which is the drug of choice for acute attack of seizure. Now all other drugs, they are generally given to prevent further recurrent attack of seizures, so they are known as anti-epileptic drug. So we continuously give anti-epileptic drug on long-term basis, and will continue this anti-epileptic drug for minimum duration of 2 years of seizure-free interval. Okay. So let's see the treatment of status epilepticus, and then we will see what are the various drugs for epilepsies. So if you talk about the treatment of status epilepticus, we start the treatment after 5 minutes. So between 5 to 30 minutes, the drug of choice is benzodiazepine, that is lorazepam. You can also use clonazepam and midazolam. If it is refractory to lorazepam, 2 injections, then we start with fosphenytoin, valproate and levetiracetam. Remember, here we have written fosphenytoin, we have not written the word phenytoin. Okay. Now if the seizures are occurring even after 30 minutes, they are known as refractory seizures. And we establish them whether they are generalized or focal. If they are generalized, we continue with benzodiazepines like midazolam or propofol. But if it is focal, we will give anti-epileptic drugs like valproate, topiramate, levetiracetam and pregabalin. If they are occurring even after 48 hours, this is known as late refractory. We will give other modalities of treatment along with phenobarbital. We put the patient on general anesthetic. We will do surgery, we will remove that part of the brain, lobectomy. We will give muscle relaxant like magnesium and verapamil, lignocaine, and we give ketogenic diet. So this is the treatment of status epilepticus. Now let's see what is the treatment of various epilepsy in long-term basis. Now epilepsy can be classified into two, generalized and focal. Remember, in generalized seizures, both hemisphere of the brains and all the neurons of the brains are firing. While in focal seizures, remember, only a group of neurons in one hemisphere of the brain is firing abnormally. So let's talk about first generalized seizure. Now generalized seizures is further divided on the basis of the body movement by which the patient will come to you. The most common type of generalized seizures are known as GTCS, that is generalized tonic-clonic seizures. They are also known as grand mal epilepsy or major epilepsy. Remember, the first line drug is valproate and lamotrigine. So overall drug of choice for GTCS is valproate. Now remember, this valproate and lamotrigine are also given in other type of generalized seizure as well. Now the second one is absence seizure. Why it is known as absence seizure? Because there is no movement. Hence it is only diagnosed on the basis of EEG, electroencephalogram. There is a typical 3 Hz wave spike pattern. Absence seizure is also known as petit mal epilepsy or minor epilepsy. Here we will give valproate and lamotrigine, but more preferred drug is ethosuximide. And rest all other types of SSAID known as myoclonic, tonic, aclonic and atypical absence. Here also we will give valproate. Valproate is the drug of choice. Lamotrigine is given. The third option is topiramate. Okay. So how to remember? Valproate and lamotrigine is written in all of the following. In absence SSAID, we will add ethosuximide. In myoclonic, atonic, tonic and atypical absence, we will add topiramate. Okay. Now what about focal SSAIDs? Focal SSAIDs, remember, there is generally that could be of two type. Either it is associated with aura or discognitive symptom or non-discognitive symptom. The first line drug for focal SSAIDs are Lokpal, that is lamotrigine, which is preferred in adult, oxcarbazepine, which is preferred in small children, carbamazepine, phenytoin and levetiracetam. So these are the first line drug. So among them, oxcarbazepine and lamotrigine are most preferred drug. Okay. Now, if you talk about certain miscellaneous causes of SSAIDs, they are known as epilepsy syndrome. So the first cause of syndrome is juvenile myoclonic epilepsy, which occurs in teenage. Remember, here the myoclonic word is coming, and three drugs we have already discussed are effective against myoclonic epilepsy, that is valproate, lamotrigine and topiramate. Okay. And the drug of choice for myoclonic SSAID, remember, is valproate because it is the most effective drug. But if this juvenile myoclonic epilepsy is occurring in pregnancy, remember valproate is the most teratogenic drug. Here the drug of choice will be levetiracetam. In myoclonic epilepsy, phenytoin and carbamazepine are absolutely contraindicated. Okay. Now the second myoclonic type of SSAID, which is a very rare cause of epilepsy, is Lennox-Gastaut syndrome. Okay. It occurs in small children associated with mental retardation. Here again we give valproate, lamotrigine and topiramate just like above. But we have developed two drugs specifically for Lennox-Gastaut. One is rufinamide and in resistant cases we give felbamate. We can add clobazam to valproate also. So combination of valproate and clobazam is the treatment for Lennox-Gastaut. In resistant cases we give rufinamide and last resort we give felbamate. Then we have Dravet syndrome, again a myoclonic epilepsy of infancy. Again we give valproate, lamotrigine, topiramate. Valproate is the drug of choice. Stiripentol is a new safest drug in Dravet syndrome. It's a barbiturate. Then we have mesial temporal lobe epilepsy. Here there is a role of surgery because there is sclerosis of a part of a brain. Rolandic epilepsy, carbamazepine. Catamenial epilepsy associated with menstrual cycle. What we will do? We will increase the dose of anti-epileptic. We will add progesterone hormone and acetazolamide. Okay. Now there is a drug epilepsy known as infantile spasm, also known as West syndrome or Hips arrhythmia. Here the drug of choice is ACTH hormone with glucocorticoid. These are hormones, not anti-epileptic drug, because they give negative feedback to CRH hormone, corticotropin releasing hormone, which is epileptogenic. In resistant cases, in recurrence, or if this infantile spasm is associated with an autosomal dominant condition known as tuberous sclerosis, the drug of choice for infantile spasm is vigabatrin. So vigabatrin, remember, is an orphan drug. It's a very rare cause of epilepsy. A new drug for infantile spasm is ganoxolone. Then we discuss about febrile SSAID, which occurs in very small children due to high grade fever. The drug of choice for acute attack of febrile SSAID is intravenous diazepam. If intravenous route is not available, you can give rectal diazepam or you can also give intranasal midazolam because veins in small children are difficult to access. Now, if it is occurring again and again intermittently, the drug of choice is rectal diazepam. You can also give valproate. To decrease fever, you can give paracetamol and brufen. Okay. So this is all about the treatment of epilepsy. Now let's talk about anti-epileptic drugs. Now anti-epileptic drugs, remember, they will suppress a neuron in the brain. They will inhibit the depolarization of neuron. You know that depolarization of neuron occurs due to inward movement of positive charge like sodium and calcium. So the first class of drug we have which will inhibit use-dependent sodium channel, the drug which will inhibit T-type of calcium channels. We can promote negative charge inside the cell. The cell will become hyperpolarized. So we can open GABA-A chloride channel. And we can remove positive charge from the cell by opening potassium channel. And lastly, we can inhibit the release of excitatory glutamate neurotransmitter which spread epilepsy. Okay. So these are the five channels, five areas of anti-epileptic drug. Sodium blocker and calcium channel blocker, chloride and potassium opener and inhibit the release of glutamate. Okay, inhibit the release of glutamate. So keep this thing in mind. Now let's see what are the drugs we have among antiepileptic. Now the first drug we will have, the drug which will block sodium channel. Their use dependent blockage means they block the sodium channel in open and inactive state. The drugs are PCV-TOL, P for phenytoin, C for carbamazepine. They only block sodium channel. Then we have multi-ion channel blocker like valproate, topiramate, lamotrigine, lecosamide. They block other channel as well. Okay. We have modified lecosamide into zonisamide and rufinamide. Okay. We have modified into rufinamide and zonisamide. Now the second class of drug we have is the drug which block T type of calcium channel. Remember, T type of calcium channel, T word stands for transient. It is present in thalamus. Remember, thalamus is the sensory part of the brain. Hence, if the neurons are firing in the sensory lobe of the brain, it will not produce any body movement. Remember, defect in T type of calcium channel causes absence seizures, because in absence seizure there is no convulsions, no body movement. Now there are four drugs which are approved for absence seizure which will block T type of calcium channel, that is VELT, valproate, ethosuximide, lamotrigine and trimethadione. Trimethadione was the first drug to be developed for absence seizure, but now it has been banned. Now there are two upcoming drugs which can block T type of calcium channel, that is clonazepam and zonisamide. But you have to remember the word VELT. Now let's see what is the difference. What is the difference between T type of calcium channel and the difference between sodium channel? Remember, these sodium channels are present in cortex, and from cortex motor nerves can come which can cause movement, which can cause GTCS and focal seizure. But if you see this red part, thalamus, which is a sensory part, it only contains calcium channel. If the neurons of this thalamus will fire, remember, no body movement will occur and this will cause absence seizure. Now we have a drug which only and only block T type of calcium channel, that is ethosuximide. Hence ethosuximide is only used in absence seizure and it is the drug of choice. And we have a drug which will only block sodium channel, that is phenytoin, carbamazepine and topiramate. They are only used in GTCS and focal seizure. They are not used in absence seizure. Similarly, ethosuximide is not used in GTCS and focal seizure. Now we have a drug which can block both calcium channel and sodium channel, that is valproate and lamotrigine. Hence valproate and lamotrigine are given in all types of seizures. All types of seizure we give valproate and lamotrigine. Understood this diagram? Okay. Now next we have the drug which will promote GABA action. So the first drug which will increase the synthesis of GABA from glutamate is valproate. Then we have a drug which increase the release of GABA from the nerves, that is pregabalin and gabapentin. They block certain calcium channel. Then we have a drug which can directly stimulate GABA A chloride receptor, that is barbiturate and benzodiazepine. The drug which will inhibit the reuptake of GABA from released portion, that is tiagabine. Tiagabine inhibit GAT transporter. Then we have a drug which inhibit the degradation of GABA by GABA transaminase. The drug is V-gabatrin. How to remember V? GABA means GABA, TR means transaminase, IN means inhibitor, and valproate also. Then we have ganoxolone, which is a neurosteroid which increases the binding of GABA to its receptor. Then we have a drug which inhibits glutamate. The drug which inhibits release of glutamate by inhibiting the fusion of vesicles levetiracetam. Okay, it is derived from a nootropic drug, memory enhancing drug piracetam. It inhibits synaptic vesicular 2A protein, hence it inhibits the release of glutamate from the nerves. Now when this glutamate is released, it acts on its receptor known as NMDA, AMP and kinate, which causes seizures in other neurons. They all are sodium block channels. So we have a drug which block NMDA receptor, that is felbamate. Then we have a drug which block AMPA receptor of glutamate, that is pirampanel, telempanel. They have AMPA word in between. Then we have a drug which will block both AMP and kinate receptor, that is topiramate and phenobarbital. Okay. So these are the drugs which block glutamate receptors. So let's talk about the history of anti-epileptic drug. The first anti-epileptic drug which we developed was bromide. It was a highly sedative drug and it is now not used in human, it is used in animals. The first anti-epileptic drug which is given in cases nowadays used, which was developed, was barbiturate. The problem with barbiturate was it was highly sedative and it is a very narrow safety margin. Hence, we develop a safer alternative to barbiturate, which is also highly sedative, that is benzodiazepine. Then we develop phenytoin. Now, phenytoin was the first non-sedative anti-epileptic drug we made. Okay, again, it is a very unsafe drug. That is why we made carbamazepine and oxcarbazepine. As compared to phenytoin, they are much safer. Then we made valproate, because valproate is the first drug which among them which is effective for absent seizure. Then we made lamotrigine, compared to valproate, more safer. Then we developed other newer congeners. So let's talk about the first drug, that is phenytoin. Now phenytoin is also known as diphenylhydantoin. So you can combine this word, phenytoin will come. It only blocks sodium channel. It is used in epilepsy, focal seizure and GTCS. Remember, phenytoin and carbamazepine, they are not effective in absence seizure because they don't block T type of calcium channels and they are contraindicated in myoclonic seizures. It is also given in antiarrhythmic drug. It is also given in trigeminal neuralgia, where the drug of choice is carbamazepine. Remember, phenytoin is a non-sedative anti-epileptic drug. It does not suppress CNS. Now, what is the route of administration? It is given orally. We have modified this phenytoin into fosphenytoin, which is given IV as a fast injection. Hence, it is given in status epilepticus. Now, all anti-epileptic drug, remember, they bind to albumin. Phenytoin is metabolized by CYP2C9 and it shows zero order kinetics. It's a narrow therapeutic index drug and the blood levels of phenytoin should be between 10 to 20 microgram per ml. More than 20 will cause toxicity. Okay? So this is all about phenytoin. Let's talk about the side effect of phenytoin. The side effect of phenytoin will come in higher dose, which is known as toxicity. It can be preventable by reducing the dose. There are three, that is CCC, cerebellar toxicity, like ataxia, nystagmus, diplopia and vertigo. Cerebral, remember, it is non-sedative, it just causes mood changes, and in cardiac it causes bradycardia. Now certain side effects of phenytoin, it comes in normal dose or even at low dose. They will start from the word H. The most common side effect of phenytoin is hyperplasia of gums. It also causes hirsutism like acne, PCOD and weight gain. Okay, it is mainly seen in females. It causes hypersensitivity or allergic reaction. Remember, if there is allergic reaction to phenytoin, it's an indication to stop phenytoin. It inhibits insulin release, it causes hyperglycemia. Remember, it causes various vitamin deficiencies. It causes deficiency of folic acid by inhibiting absorption. Hence, it may cause megaloblastic anemia, MCV will increase. Remember, phenobarbital and valproate also causes folic acid deficiency, which is not seen with carbamazepine. So these are the drugs which causes folic acid deficiency: phenytoin, phenobarbital and valproate. It also causes vitamin K deficiency, which can lead to hemorrhage. It may also cause hypocalcemia by vitamin D deficiency. Remember, vitamin K deficiency leads to osteomalacia. Vitamin K is needed for bone formation. It is teratogenic. It mainly causes cleft lip and cleft palate, known as Hydantoin syndrome. It causes pseudolymphoma or Hodgkin's lymphoma. It inhibits ADH. It causes heavy urination. Remember, phenytoin inhibits ADH. Carbamazepine increases ADH. So phenytoin inhibits ADH, carbamazepine increases ADH, that is why carbamazepine causes SIADH, it causes hyponatremia by carbamazepine. It also causes purple glove syndrome. So let's talk about carbamazepine, the same effect like phenytoin, exactly same. Okay, it is, as compared to phenytoin, is much safer. It's an enzyme inducer, it induces its own metabolism. Remember, all anti-epileptic are enzyme inducer except valproate. The side effect of carbamazepine are shades. It causes Stevens-Johnson syndrome. But maximum Stevens-Johnson is by lamotrigine. It is hepatotoxic, and when it is added to valproate, the hepatotoxicity risk further increases. It causes aplastic anemia and agranulocytosis due to bone marrow suppression. It causes cerebellar toxicity like diplopia, nystagmus, eosinophilia and SIADH. In SIADH, remember, there is hyponatremia. Okay? It also causes neural tube defect, but remember, maximum neural tube defect is by valproate. Now, new congeners are oxcarbazepine and escitalopram. They are less enzyme inducer and they have less side effect. They are preferred in low children, but they should not be given in old age because they cause more SIADH in elderly people. Now, let's talk about the very famous drug valproate. Now, valproate is a broad spectrum drug. It acts in every channel: sodium channel, calcium channel, GABA, etc. Okay, it also has genetic effect on genes by histone deacetylase inhibitor. Now, where valproate is used? It is used in all types of epilepsy. It is given in rapid cycling bipolar disorder drug of choice. It is also given in migraine prophylaxis. It is not given in neuropathic pain. Remember, in neuropathic pain, we give phenytoin and carbamazepine. Now, it's an enzyme inhibitor among all anti-epileptic drugs. Now, the most common side effect of valproate is nausea and vomiting. It causes PCOD because ovaries are present in females only, so it's a gender-specific effect which is associated with weight gain, alopecia, acne, and hirsutism. So, the side effect is PP, PCOD, and pancreatitis. It causes tremors. It causes thrombocytopenia. It is hepatotoxic. Remember, hepatotoxicity with valproate increases when we add other anti-epileptic drugs to valproate, like carbamazepine. Plus, it increases ammonia level in the blood, which may lead to hyperammonemic encephalopathy. Now, hepatotoxicity is mainly seen in small children. Hence, valproate should be avoided in small children, but remember, it is not contraindicated. Okay? Now, topiramate, remember, it has all action except it does not act on T-type of calcium channel. Okay? That is why topiramate is not given in absent seizure. Remember, topiramate, it also has carbonic anhydrase inhibiting property. Because of this reason, remember, it causes renal stone, glaucoma, and pseudomyopia. It required long-term eye checkup. Remember, it is an anti-epileptic drug which causes weight loss, and it is hence approved as an anti-obesity drug. It is also an approved anti-craving drug for alcohol. Okay? Now, these are the effect of anti-epileptic drug on weight. Topiramate, zonisamide, and felbamate causes weight loss. The first two drugs are approved as an anti-obesity drug. Weight gain is by phenytoin, valproate, pregabalin, and gabapentin. Now, what about epilepsy in pregnancy? Remember, no anti-epileptic drug is contraindicated in pregnancy. If a female is taking an anti-epileptic drug and she became pregnant, continue with that same anti-epileptic drug even though it is teratogenic. And we must continue for minimum of 2 years. Now, so the best treatment is continue old anti-epileptic drug in pregnancy. But just add folic acid and vitamin K. Folic acid is given 500 microgram per day and vitamin K is given 10 milligram per day only in the last month of delivery. But if a female gives you a history of neural tube defect or the female is on valproate, give 10 times dose of folic acid, that is 4000 micrograms per day. The most teratogenic drug is valproate, but remember, valproate is not contraindicated. The safest anti-epileptic drug in pregnancy is lamotrigine, and hence it is considered drug of choice, while in juvenile myoclonic epilepsy we give levetiracetam. They both are category C. Okay, so this is all about epilepsy in a nutshell. Keeping this thing in mind, let's solve the question. The first question is asking gender specific side effect of valproate. Remember, PCOD, polycystic ovarian disease. How to remember? Remember, ovaries are only present in females. Okay, ovaries are only present in females. Now, all of the following adverse effects are associated with carbamazepine. I have already told you the side effect of carbamazepine, that is shades. Okay, it causes Stevens-Johnson syndrome. True, it is hepatotoxic. It causes aplastic anemia. It causes diplopia and nystagmus due to cerebellar toxicity. Because it is neurotoxic. Because of neurotoxicity, eosinophilia. And it causes SIADH. More ADH level will lead to hyponatremia. So these are the side effects of carbamazepine, which I have already told you. So neurotoxicity, true. It is teratogenic, true. It decreases the level of ADH. Now, this is a false statement. It rather increases the level of ADH, SIADH. Hypersensitivity, true. That is why it causes Stevens-Johnson syndrome. So, remember the point that the anti-epileptic drug which increases the level of ADH is carbamazepine. Okay? That is why carbamazepine causes hyponatremia. Because an increase in ADH level causes hyponatremia. The anti-epileptic drug which decreases ADH level is phenytoin. That is why phenytoin causes hypernatremia. Okay? So, ADH is increased by carbamazepine, reduced by phenytoin. So, the answer out here is C. It rather increases ADH level. Which of the following drugs can be used in juvenile myoclonic epilepsy in pregnancy? If the word pregnancy is coming, the drug of choice is levetiracetam. Okay, the drug of choice is levetiracetam. If pregnancy word is not given, remember the drug of choice for GME is valproate. But remember, valproate is most teratogenic drug. So if there is an option to start a new drug, we will start with levetiracetam. Okay, so I'll show you the treatment of juvenile myoclonic epilepsy again. So the drugs which are given in juvenile myoclonic epilepsies are, we will write, so this was the treatment of juvenile myoclonic epilepsy, I've told you. So in pregnancy, as you can see, the drug of choice is levetiracetam. Overall drug of choice is valproate. Phenytoin and carbamazepine are contraindicated in myoclonic epilepsy. So which of the following drugs are given in myoclonic epilepsy? Remember, three drugs, VLT. They are given always in myoclonic epilepsy: valproate, lamotrigine, and topiramate. They are given in all types of myoclonic epilepsy. There are two drugs which are contraindicated in myoclonic epilepsy, that is phenytoin and carbamazepine. Why? Because they aggravate this myoclonic epilepsy. Okay, so you will go by the answer out here, that is phenytoin. Phenytoin is never given out in myoclonic epilepsy. Zonisamide and levetiracetam, they are second line drugs for myoclonic epilepsy. Valproate is overall the drug of choice. Phenytoin and carbamazepine are absolutely contraindicated. Now, drug of choice for myoclonic epilepsy in pregnancy. Now, answer should be here, levetiracetam. Now, remember, as the word levetiracetam is not given, so you will go by the answer. Because phenytoin is contraindicated, carbamazepine is contraindicated, and phenobarbital is not effective. Hence, you will go by the answer, valproate. Okay, but the best answer is levetiracetam. Which of the following statement about anti-epileptics is false? Phenytoin, valproate and carbamazepine, they act by prolonging inactivated sodium channel. This is absolutely true. Okay, so I've already told you PCV-TOL. That is phenytoin, carbamazepine, valproate, topiramate, lamotrigine and lacosamide, they block sodium channel. Diazepam is anticonvulsant. Yes, it's a benzodiazepine. It is given as an anticonvulsant drug. Absolutely true. Okay. Lamotrigine act by causing GABA mediated chloride channel. Now this is false. Remember, lamotrigine has only two action. It only blocks sodium channel and it only blocks T type of calcium channel. It has no action on GABA. It has no action on glutamate. So, lamotrigine has only sodium and calcium inhibiting property. So, this is a false statement. Hence, the answer for the option comes out to be C. False. Carbamazepine is used in trigeminal neuralgia. It's a true statement. It is the drug of choice for trigeminal neuralgia. Now, which anti-epileptic drug does not act by inhibiting sodium channel? So, if I'll show you that list of sodium channel inhibitor again. So these are the drugs which inhibit sodium channel, that is PCB-TOL, phenytoin, carbamazepine, valproate, topiramate, lamotrigine and lacosamide. Two brothers of lacosamide are zonisamide and rufinamide. So the answer out here, you can see carbamazepine true, phenytoin true, lamotrigine true. So the answer out here is vigabatrin. Remember vigabatrin, how you can remember? GABA means GABA. TR means transaminase, IN means inhibitor. Vigabatrin is a GABA transaminase inhibitor. It inhibits the degradation of GABA, hence the level of GABA increases. Where it is used? It is the drug of choice for infantile spas, which is associated with tuberous sclerosis. Okay, side effect comes out to be VI. VI word is remaining. The side effect is visual disturbance. Okay, it causes visual field constriction. Vigabatrin. Now, which of the following drugs act by affecting the level of GABA? So, I'll show you that slide again, the drugs acting on GABA. So, the drug which increases the synthesis of GABA, valproate. Release of GABA, pregabalin and gabapentin. Acting on GABA receptor, barbiturate, benzodiazepine. Inhibit uptake of GABA, tiagabine. Inhibit degradation of GABA, vigabatrin and valproate. A act increasing the binding of GABA, ganoxolone. So, which of the following drugs act by increasing, affecting the levels of GABA? Okay, तो वेलप्रोएट ट्रू. रिमेंबर वेलप्रोएट इंक्रीज द लेवल ऑफ गाबा फॉर्मेशन एंड इट ऑल्सो डिक्रीज द डिग्रेडेशन. इथोसेक्सिमाइड फॉल्स. इथोसेक्सिमाइड ओनली एक्ट ऑन कैल्शियम चैनल. फेनिटॉइन फॉल्स. कार्बामेजपिन दे ओनली ब्लॉक सोडियम चैनल. सो द आंसर आउट हेयर कम्स आउट टू बी वेलप्रोएट. रिमेंबर वेलप्रोएट एक्ट एट ऑल्स रिसेप्टर. सोडियम कैल्शियम गाबा ग्लूटामेट एवरीवेयर. The fetal hydantoin is seen with which of the following? Hydantoin is another name of phenytoin. Because phenytoin is also known as diphenylhydantoin. Another name of phenytoin is diphenylhydantoin. So because of this reason, pheny word we have taken from there, pheny word, and toin word we have taken from hydantoin. So the drug became phenytoin, okay, and its main teratogenic effect in pregnancy is cleft lip and cleft palate. It causes cleft abnormality in fetus, okay. So which of the following statement about phenytoin are true? Except phenytoin does not depress CNS. It's absolutely true. It is one of the anti-epileptic drug which does not depress CNS. It is a non-sedative anti-epileptic drug. So it's a true statement. It follows saturation or zero order kinetic. It's absolutely true. Okay, we have already discussed. Now, okay, it follows saturation kinetics. It's absolutely true. Now, cerebellar degeneration occurs in long-term administration. The answer is absolutely true. It causes cerebellar toxicity. Now, anti-seizure activity closely resembles plasma concentration. Now the point is, this is also a true statement, okay? This is also a true statement, okay? So all statements are absolutely true. Now which of the following statement about phenytoin is true? It is non-teratogenic. Now this is a false. Remember, it causes cleft lip and cleft palate, which is fetal hydantoin. It shows zero order kinetic, true. It is excreted unchanged in urine, false. Remember, it is first metabolized in liver, then it is excreted unchanged in urine, okay? Then it is excreted changed in urine. First it is metabolized by CYP2C9, then it gets excreted out in change, it gets changed in liver, and then it gets excreted out in urine. It does not induce microsomal enzyme. Remember, all anti-epileptic drugs are enzyme inducer. Except valproate. Valproate is an enzyme inhibitor. Okay, so the only true statement is it follows zero order kinetic. The hirsutism, gingival hyperplasia, and granulocytopenia are the side effect of. Remember, these are the side effect of two drugs, that is phenytoin and valproate. Okay. Now the point is, you will go by the answer. It is more commonly seen with phenytoin. If you want to go by the one answer, then you will go by the word phenytoin. It is more seen commonly seen with phenytoin. A patient on, but it is also seen with valproate. Okay, a patient on phenytoin therapy develops depression, for which she was prescribed antidepressant drug. Now she complete lassitude and HB reading is, so the patient is having anemia. The hemoglobin level is less. The next step is, remember, phenytoin causes which type of anemia? Phenytoin causes folic acid deficiency. And in folic acid deficiency, remember, there is megaloblastic anemia. In megaloblastic anemia, the size of the RBC becomes big. And how we can access? We measure MCV, mean corpuscular volume. Mean corpuscular volume will tell us about the large shape of, large volume of RBC, which tells us about that it is due to megaloblastic anemia due to folic acid. So the answer is MCV. Now, regarding phenytoin, which of the following statement is wrong? It induces microsomal enzyme, true. Remember, all anti-epileptic are inducer except valproate. At higher dose, higher half-life, true. This is the classical feature of zero order kinetic. Zero order kinetic in higher dose, the drug becomes more longer acting drug. Okay, so it's absolutely true. At very low dose, it shows zero order kinetic. Remember, zero order kinetic is only seen in high dose, not in zero order. So this is a false statement. It is protein bound. Yes, true. It is albumin bound. So the false statement you will write is C. Okay, C, because zero order kinetic is only seen in high dose. And in zero order kinetic, the drug becomes longer acting because extra amount of the drug is not removed out of the body. A patient with recent onset of primarily generalized epilepsy develops skin reaction due to phenytoin. Remember, this is a classical allergic reaction or hypersensitivity to phenytoin. And hypersensitivity to phenytoin, it's an indication to stop phenytoin. Stop phenytoin and start valproate. If a patient develops allergic reaction to phenytoin, it's an indication to stop phenytoin and start valproate. So the answer will be out here is shift towards valproate. Okay, shift towards valproate. Okay. Now, adverse effect of phenytoin includes all of the following, except it causes lymphadenopathy. True, it causes pseudolymphoma. Ataxia, true, because of cerebellar degeneration. Hypercalcemia is false. It rather causes hypocalcemia. Why it causes hypocalcemia? Because it causes vitamin D deficiency. Hirsutism, true. So the false correct statement is hypercalcemia. Okay. In chronic treatment with a drug, patient presents with gingival hyperplasia and hirsutism. It is seen with, mainly seen with, most commonly seen with phenytoin. Okay, so the answer out here is phenytoin. So I'll show you the side effects of phenytoin again. Okay, so let's talk about the side effects of phenytoin. In high dose, cerebellar toxicity, cerebral toxicity, cardiac toxicity. In normal dose, hyperplasia of gum and hirsutism, which is the most common. Hypersensitivity, that means allergic reactions, stop it. Hyperglycemia, megaloblastic anemia due to folic acid deficiency, increase in MCV, mean corpuscular volume. It causes hemorrhage due to vitamin K deficiency, hypocalcemia due to vitamin D deficiency. And both of this deficiency causes bone degeneration, osteomalacia or osteoporosis. It is teratogenic, causes Hydantoin syndrome in fetus, cleft lip and cleft palate. It causes Hodgkin's-like pseudolymphoma. Heavy urination because it inhibits ADH, it causes diabetes insipidus. So all are starting with the word H. Now, which of the following are the features of phenytoin toxicity? So try to remember, gum hypertrophy, true. Okay, gum hypertrophy, it's absolutely true. Okay, but remember, it is not toxicity. Toxicity, I told you, it occurs in high dose. This gum hypertrophy occurs in normal dose. So can you tell me which of the three side effects are occurring in high dose toxicity with phenytoin? That is cerebellar toxicity, ataxia, nystagmus, diplopia and vertigo, cerebral mood changes and bradycardia in heart. These are the toxic effect of phenytoin. So this is not. So as you can see, nystagmus is written out here, which is a classical feature of cerebellar toxicity. So this is the toxic effect of phenytoin. So the only answer we have is nystagmus out here. Okay. Therapeutic level of phenytoin is 10 to 20 milligram per deciliter per ml. So this is the therapeutic level. Phenytoin pharmacokinetics is highlighted by which of the following? Remember, it shows saturation kinetics. Now, saturation kinetics is also known as capacity limited metabolism, saturation at higher therapeutic concentration. Now, what is saturation or zero order kinetic? For that whole concept, you have to refer to the complete videos. Okay. So, saturation kinetic, the body has no capacity or power to remove our drug. The capacity is limited. So, the drug is not removed, the drug is not metabolized. Hence, if you will increase the dose, the drug will accumulate in the body. High plasma concentration of phenytoin can cause which of the following adverse effect? So, high plasma concentration means toxicity. And I told you three toxic effects: ataxia, true, cerebellar. Hirsutism, false, because hirsutism occurs in normal dose. Gum hypertrophy false because it can occur in normal dose. Hence, the answer is only and only ataxia, which occurs in toxic dose or high dose. But hirsutism and hypertrophy can occur. It can occur in low and normal dose also. Pseudolymphoma is a side effect of phenytoin. It can cause lymph node swelling. Which of the following is not the side effect of phenytoin? Osteomalacia, true, because of vitamin D and vitamin K deficiency. Hypoglycemia, remember, is false. Remember, phenytoin rather causes hyperglycemia. Because phenytoin inhibits insulin release. Gum hypertrophy, true. Lymphadenopathy or pseudolymphoma, true. All are the side effects of phenytoin except osteomalacia, true, due to vitamin D and K deficiency. Gynecomastia is not seen, false. Gum hypertrophy, true. Megaloblastic anemia due to folic acid deficiency, true. Anti-epileptic drug which can cause folic acid deficiency anemia are, we will write most common phenytoin. Second, you will write phenobarbitone. Lastly, you will write valproate. These three drugs causes folic acid deficiency. It is not seen with, you will write carbamazepine. Carbamazepine don't cause folic acid deficiency anemia. It rather cause aplastic anemia. So carbamazepine rather causes aplastic anemia, which is very dangerous. And these three drugs causes folic acid deficiency anemia. Carbamazepine, aplastic anemia. So the answer is anti-epileptic drug which can cause true. False is carbamazepine. Carbamazepine does not cause folic acid deficiency. Now, osteomalacia is a side effect of phenytoin because phenytoin causes vitamin D plus vitamin K deficiency. Due to vitamin D and vitamin K deficiency, it causes osteomalacia, phenytoin. Which of the following should be avoided in pregnancy? Remember, anti-epileptic drugs should be avoided in pregnancy. But remember, they are not contraindicated. They are category D. Category D drug means that they are teratogenic. But still, if there is some life-threatening condition, we give. Insulin and heparin, they are absolutely safe in pregnancy. Okay? Insulin. It is the drug of choice for diabetes in pregnancy. Heparin is the drug of choice for anticoagulation in pregnancy. Okay, so the only answer is phenytoin. Side effects of phenytoin are all except osteomalacia, true. Rashes or allergic reaction, true. Megaloblastic anemia due to folic acid deficiency, true. So the false statement is sedation. Remember, phenytoin is a non-sedative anti-epileptic drug. That is why phenytoin is very famous, because it will not alter the lifestyle of a person. It is a non-sedative anti-epileptic drug. Side effect of phenytoin, when its plasma concentration is above the therapeutic level, it means toxicity. And I've told you 3C of toxicity. It causes gum hypertrophy, false. It occurs in normal dose level. Ataxia, true. Due to cerebellar toxicity, it may cause ataxia. So the answer for this question is ataxia. Osteomalacia and hirsutism can occur in normal dose, not in toxic dose. Folate deficiency occurs due to? The answer is all of the above. Remember, primidone is a prodrug of phenobarbitone. So the answer is all of the above, and you can also add valproate to it. So all these drugs causes folic acid deficiency. Okay? Folic acid deficiency. Which of the following statement about phenytoin is accurate? It displaces sulfonamides from plasma proteins. Now, this is a false statement. Okay. It doesn't displace. It is the drug of choice for myoclonic epilepsy. False. Remember, it is contraindicated in myoclonic seizure. Half-life is increased if it is used with phenobarbitone. False. Remember, phenobarbitone is an enzyme inducer. It will rather increase the metabolism or increase the degradation of phenytoin. Hence, because of this reason, half-life of phenytoin will rather decrease, not increase. So the last statement is toxicity might occur will increase in slight increase in the dose. The answer is true. If we little bit increase the dose of phenytoin, we know toxic effect may come because it's a narrow therapeutic index drug. Because phenytoin is narrow therapeutic index drug, that means it has low safety margin. Low safety margin means if you will little bit increase the dose, the toxicity might come. The side effect of diphenylhydrantoin, that is phenytoin, is gum hyperplasia, true. Acute cerebellar syndrome, yes, it causes cerebellar toxicity. It causes megaloblastic anemia, true. Except that is internuclear ophthalmoplegia. It doesn't cause internuclear ophthalmoplegia. There is no eye defect. A 65-year-old patient presented with hospital with focal seizures. His renal functions are normal. Which of the following drug of choice? Now, the drug of choice for focal seizures is 2. Either lamotrigine or you will give carbamazepine. I have already told you a mnemonic, Lokpal. So, go by the answer, the modification of carbamazepine, that is oxcarbazepine. It's a modification of carbamazepine. So, I'll show you the drug of choice for the treatment of focal seizures. Okay. So, the drugs which are used for the treatment of focal seizure, the mnemonic is, the first line drug, the main drugs are Lokpal, lamotrigine, oxcarbazepine, carbamazepine, phenytoin and levetiracetam. This is the decreasing order of preference. The first two drugs are the drug of choice, lamotrigine and oxcarbazepine. Okay. Now, a pregnant woman with a primarily generalized tonic-clonic seizure, that is GTCS, well controlled on phenobarbital, stops taking her anti-epileptic drug 4 months to her pregnancy. Which of the following best describes her decision? Her decision is wrong. It is absolutely true. Her decision is wrong. A female should take anti-epileptic drug continuously in pregnancy, even if the drug is teratogenic. As the risk of teratogenic was highest in first trimester, so this is a true statement. Okay? So, this is a true statement. Now, her decision is wrong because anti-epileptic drugs do not increase the risk of fetal malformation. False. They rather increase the risk of fetal malformation. Okay. And remember, teratogenicity is due to organ malformation. Organ forms in first trimester. Her decision is correct. No, it is not correct. As the risk of seizure is reduced, remember, her decision is wrong. A female should take phenobarbital or anti-epileptic drug during pregnancy. Her decision is wrong, but her medication need to be changed. Remember, the main treatment is to continue old anti-epileptic drug. So remember, anti-epileptic drug, her medication should not be changed. Okay, it should not be changed. Okay. So the only true statement is first A. Ethosuximide is only given, it only blocks T-type of calcium channel. And it only blocks T-type of calcium channel, hence it is only given for which seizures? Absent seizures. Okay, so the only use of ethosuximide is absent seizure. The drug of choice for prevention of seizures in a patient of severe preeclampsia. Now the drug of choice for eclampsia and preeclampsia, prevention of seizure, is magnesium sulfate. The magnesium sulfate is given in cases of preeclampsia, that is seizures in pregnancy. Okay, magnesium sulfate. Which of the following is the earliest sign of magnesium toxicity? That point I have already told you in asthma. The earliest sign of magnesium toxicity is loss of deep tendon reflex or knee jerk. Because magnesium inhibits entry of calcium into the muscle, hence the tendon will not contract. Hence, the knee jerk will not come. Magnesium can be administered in. Now, magnesium is given in all of the following. Okay. All of the following. Okay. Now, let's see the uses of magnesium. Magnesium, it is given as a in torsades de pointis. First use is torsades de pointis, which is a type of cardiac arrhythmias. So magnesium is given in the treatment of cardiac arrhythmia, true. It is given as antacid. It is given in barium and calcium poisoning. Remember, in hypercalcemia or calcium poisoning, sometimes there could be tetany. So this is also true. Tetany can be seen in hypocalcemia as well as hyper also. Then we will write it is a laxative. It is used for the treatment of constipation. Okay. It is given, it is the drug of choice for seizures in pregnancy, eclampsia. It is given as a tocolytic drug for relaxation of uterus. And lastly, it is also given in asthma known as status asthmaticus. Okay. So these are the uses of magnesium. Now how to remember? Write a mnemonic tablets. So remember it is given in everything. Okay. Eclampsia, seizures, arrhythmias. Seizures are types of eclampsia and seizures are same thing. So it is used everywhere. Which of the following are the adverse effect of sodium valproate except? Sodium valproate, let's see the side effect of sodium valproate. Let's see that slide again. So if you talk about the side effect of sodium valproate, so these were the side effect. The most common side effect is nausea and vomiting. Second most common side effect is tremor. It causes PCOD and pancreatitis, thrombocytopenia, hepatotoxicity, mainly in small children and hyperammonemic encephalopathy. So these are the side effects. Keep this thing in mind. It causes weight gain, true, because it is associated with PCOD. It causes alopecia, true. It causes liver damage, true. Osteomalacia, remember, false. Osteomalacia is not seen with valproate, it is rather seen with phenytoin. So phenytoin causes osteomalacia, not by valproate. Okay? Because phenytoin causes vitamin D and K deficiency. Which is statement is true about carbamazepine? It is given in trigeminal neuralgia, true. It is the drug of choice. It's an enzyme inhibitor, false. Remember, all anti-epileptic drugs are enzyme inducers. Except valproate. It causes megaloblastic anemia. Again, it's a false. It rather causes aplastic anemia. It does not cause folic acid deficiency. It is the drug of choice for status epilepticus. False. Remember, the drug of choice for status epilepticus is IV lorazepam. So the only true statement you are finding is A. It is the drug of choice for trigeminal neuralgia. Okay. Now, first drug to be given in absent seizures. Okay. Remember, the drug of choice or the safest drug in absent seizure is ethosuximide. If ethosuximide is not given in the option, then you will go by the answer valproate. If valproate is not given in the option, then you will go by the answer lamotrigine. This is the order of preference. Hence, you will go by the answer out here valproate. Okay. Which of the following is not an anti-convulsant or anti-epileptic drug? The answer is flunarizine. Remember, flunarizine is a calcium channel blocker which is given for the treatment of migraine. Okay. Phenytoin, topiramate, phenobarbital are anti-epileptic or anti-convulsant drug. Prolonged use of which of the following anti-convulsant drug produces weight loss? I told you three anti-epileptic drug which causes weight loss. That is topiramate, zonisamide, and lastly felbamate. So these three anti-epileptic drug causes weight loss, and the first two drugs are approved as an anti-obesity drug. Felbamate right now is not approved. Okay. Very soon it will get approved. So the answer out here you will find to be valproate. Remember, rest all other drugs are causing will cause weight gain. Rest other drugs causes weight gain. Which of the following agent act on GABAergic system to decrease the uptake of GABA? The drug which inhibit reuptake of GABA. So GABA which is released is reuptaken by a transporter known as GAT1. GAT stands for GABA A transporter. This transporter is inhibited by a drug tiagabine. And this tiagabine is used as a second line add-on drug in cases of focal seizures. Okay. So the answer out here is tiagabine. Okay. A 30-year-old epileptic female on phenytoin therapy developed weakness and fatigue. The blood hemoglobin level is less, so the female is anemic. The MCV level is high. So and it's a classical picture of megaloblastic anemia due to folate deficiency. Okay. And we know that phenytoin causes megaloblastic anemia due to folic acid deficiency? So the answer out here, you will go by the option that is megaloblastic anemia. Okay. Which of the following is correctly matched? Gabapentin, GABA-transaminase inhibitor, false. Remember, gabapentin rather increase the release of GABA. Okay. Zonisamide with a calcium channel blocker, true. Zonisamide and clonazepam are the two drugs which are calcium channel blocker recently seen. Carbamazepine sodium channel blocker, true. PCB toll. Lamotrigine NMDA receptor blocker, false. Tiagabine increase the release of GABA, false. It inhibits the reuptake of GABA. So the only true statement is B and C. Which of the following drugs are used in GTCS? Okay. In GTCS, remember, the drugs which are used in GTCS are, the drug of choice is valproate and lamotrigine, B and C. Ethosuximide is only given in absent seizure. Propofol is a general anesthetic agent. It is not given as an anti-epileptic drug. So the answer is B and C. Okay. Answer is B and C. Which of the following is true about vigabatrin? It blocks the neuronal uptake of GABA. Now this is a false statement. It does not block the uptake of GABA. It rather inhibit degradation of GABA by inhibiting GABA transaminase enzyme. Okay. It is the drug of choice for absent seizure, false. Remember, in absent seizure, we only use three drug, valproate, ethosuximide and lamotrigine. It may lead to life-threatening skin disorder. The answer is false. It may lead to visual disturbances. I have already told you, vigabatrin, VI word means visual disturbances. So the true statement is D. It causes constriction of visual field, permanent loss of vision. Hence, a person required long-term eye checkup. Drug used in absent seizures having narrow spectrum of anti-epileptic activity is, remember, valproate and lamotrigine. Okay, sorry, valproate and lamotrigine. True, true. Primidone is not effective in absent seizure, while ethosuximide is a very safe drug. It has no narrow spectrum of activity. So the answer is lamotrigine and valproate. These two drugs require monitoring. Ethosuximide is a very safe drug. It will not require any monitoring. Okay. It will not require any monitoring. Okay. So, if you want to go by the option, A and B are the answer. Okay. Now, the most common adverse effect of valproate seen in young children. The most common side effect of valproate is nausea and vomiting. And the second most common side effect of valproate is muscle tremors. I have already told you. So the answer is tremors. Second most common is tremors. A patient Rupam was diagnosed to have febrile seizures in pediatric emergency. Which of the following drug is given for its treatment? So I'll just show you the treatment of febrile seizures again. So you will be able to answer the option. So if you talk about the treatment of febrile seizure, for acute attack, we give intravenous or rectal diazepam. We can also give intranasal midazolam. For intermittent, if it is occurring again and again, you can give rectal diazepam, valproate, paracetamol and brufen. Okay. So if you see the option out here, you are only finding the answer out here is rectal diazepam. Okay. Okay. And rectal diazepam is given for acute attack in pediatric emergency. Okay. Acute attack. Valproate is given for long-term intermittent attack. Now, which of the following about lamotrigine is true? Now, lamotrigine is a dopaminergic agonist used in Parkinson's disease. Now, this is a false statement. Lamotrigine is rather an anti-epileptic drug. It blocks glutamate receptor, false. Remember, lamotrigine only blocks sodium receptors and T type of calcium receptors only. It blocks sodium and calcium channel only. It has broad spectrum of anti-epileptic drug, true. Remember, lamotrigine and valproate are given in all epilepsy. Valproate and lamotrigine, they are given in all types of epilepsy, all types of seizure. Hence, they are the broadest spectrum drug. It suppresses tonic-clonic seizure, true, yes. But it worsens absent seizure, no. It is rather used for the treatment of absent seizure because it also blocks calcium channel. So, this statement is half true and half false. So, the false statement is it doesn't worsen absent seizure. It is rather used for the treatment of absent seizure. So, again, it is a false statement. Status epilepticus is best managed by, remember, the drug of choice for status epilepticus is intravenous benzodiazepine. And among benzodiazepine, it's intravenous lorazepam. But as you can see, lorazepam is not given in the answer. Hence, you will go by the answer intravenous diazepam, another benzodiazepine. Okay. Now, anti-epileptic drug implicated in causing toxic epidermal necrosis, which is also known as, in milder form is known as Stevens-Johnson syndrome. Now, this Stevens-Johnson syndrome or toxic epidermolytic necrosis, it is most common seen with lamotrigine. And the second drug which causes less than lamotrigine is carbamazepine. So, these two drugs, they cause Stevens-Johnson syndrome, toxic epidermolytic necrosis, most common by lamotrigine. Next drug most common will be carbamazepine. So, as you can see, lamotrigine is given in the option. It is the most common drug which causes Stevens-Johnson toxic epidermolytic necrosis. A Mohit, a 12-year-old boy, is having difficulty in learning at school with short lapses of awareness in eyes, sluttering every 5 to 10 minutes. ECG reveals 3 Hertz wave spike discharge. Now, this is a classical discharge of absent seizure. In absent seizure, this 3 Hertz wave spike pattern is seen. This is a classical feature of absent seizure. Which of the following drug would be effective but has a disadvantage that it causes sedation and tolerance? Now remember, in absent seizure, 3 drugs are effective. That is ethosuximide, valproate, and lamotrigine. These 3 drugs are effective in absent seizure. Now the point is, ethosuximide is drug of choice. And remember, it is non-sedative. While lamotrigine and valproate, remember, they are sedative drug. Okay? And in long term, they can cause sedation. So diazepam, it is not used, false. Ethosuximide can be given. Clonazepam is not given. Valproate is also given. But remember, valproate causes sedation. Hence, we will not go by the answer valproate. The answer out here will be ethosuximide. Okay, ethosuximide is the answer. If you see by the option, it is asking that which drug causes sedation. The drug which causes sedation and tolerance is valproate. So you will go by the answer out here, the drug which has a side effect of sedation, that is valproate. Okay, so this question is asking which drug produces sedation and tolerance. Then the answer is valproate, because ethosuximide is a non-sedative anti-epileptic drug. A young male, Bhupinder, suffers from seizure disorder, which is characterized by tonic rigidity of limbs. So it is GTCS type of seizures. Okay, and massive jerking followed by clonic phase. So this is which seizure? GTCS, generalized tonic-clonic seizure. And remember, in generalized tonic-clonic seizure, there are 2 drug of choice, either valproate or lamotrigine. If both options are given, you will go by the answer valproate. Hence, the answer is valproate. Okay, valproate. So, I'll show you this treatment of epilepsy, the drug of choice for various epilepsy in short form. So, this is the treatment of epilepsy. In first, you are seeing in left GTCS. The drug of choice is lamotrigine and valproate. Focal, the mnemonic I have told you, Lokpal. atypical absence, continue with lamotrigine and valproate, add ethosuximide. And in all other seizures, continue with valproate and lamotrigine, add topiramate. Okay. An anti-epileptic drug which can also be used for the treatment of post-herpetic neuralgia and pain due to diabetic neuropathy are two. Okay. The drug of choice among anti-epileptic drug for post-herpetic neuralgia and diabetic neuropathy is gabapentin. Okay. But if the option asks about trigeminal neuralgia, then your answer will be carbamazepine. So all these are the types of neuropathic pain. So post-herpetic neuralgia and diabetic neuropathy, the drug of choice is gabapentin. But if it is due to trigeminal neuralgia, you will go by the answer carbamazepine. So the answer out here is gabapentin. Okay. So gabapentin is the correct answer out here. Okay. Now, which of the following would you like to give to pregnant lady to decrease the effect of neural tube defect? Remember, neural tube defect occurred due to folic acid deficiency, hence give folic acid. Okay. Now remember, normal dose of folic acid is generally 400 micrograms. But if a female gives you a history of previous neural tube defect, or the female is on valproate, give 10 times dose, that is 4000 micrograms of folic acid in these two conditions, which is equivalent to 4 milligram of folic acid. Okay. So if a female gives you a history of neural tube defect and valproate, give 10 times dose of folic acid. Normal is around 400 to 500. Now carbamazepine in elderly, remember, it causes hyponatremia. Why? Because it causes increase in ADH level known as SIADH, and ADH level causes dilutional hyponatremia. Management of typical febrile seizure includes all of the following: tepid sponge true, paracetamol and brufen, intermittent diazepam true, prophylactic phenobarbital. No, we don't give phenobarbital. We rather give valproate. Okay. Drug of choice for infantile spasm, remember, is ACTH hormone. Okay. ACTH hormone is the drug of choice for infantile spasm, because ACTH hormone will give negative feedback to corticotropin releasing hormone. Corticotropin releasing hormone causes epilepsy. Okay. Drug of choice for trigeminal neuralgia, I have already told you, that is carbamazepine. Carbamazepine is the drug of choice for trigeminal neuralgia. Anti-epileptic drug which affect the level of GABA, valproate, true. Ethosuximide, no, false. It only affect calcium. Phenytoin and carbamazepine, not true, because they only affect sodium, while valproate act everywhere. Which of the following drug is used to treat status epilepticus? The answer, the drug of choice is benzodiazepine, that is diazepam. The best answer here would have been lorazepam. But remember, lorazepam is not given, hence you will go by another benzodiazepine, diazepam. Among the following structure which is not used for treating epilepsy: barbiturate, true, phenobarbital is used. Hydantoin, true, phenytoin, yes, it is given. Acetyl urea. Remember, acetyl ureas, the drugs are generally ethosuximide. Ectropin is not used. Remember, ectropin is generally anti-muscarinic agent. It is not an anti-epileptic agent. So the answer here would best will be ectropine. Okay, ectropine. Drug of choice in partial complex seizure. Remember, partial complex seizure, now their name have been changed to focal seizures. And for focal seizures, I have told you a mnemonic, Lokpal. That is lamotrigine, oxcarbazepine and carbamazepine. So the best answer out here, you will go with carbamazepine, which is also known as carbazepine. Okay. Now, which of the following anti-epileptic drug doesn't act by modulating sodium channel? The answer is phenytoin, true, valproate, true, lamotrigine, true. Try to remember that mnemonic, PCB, TOL. Sodium channel blocker. So the answer out here is vigabatrin. So repeat question. Anti-epileptic drug used as pain relieving, पेन रिलीविंग एनल्जेसिक, दे आर गिवन इन न्यूरोपैथिक पेन. सो विच एंटी एपिलेप्टिक ड्रग्स आर गिवन इन न्यूरोपैथिक पेन? वी विल राइट कार्बामेजेपिन. We also give, we will write phenytoin. We give gabapentin. We also give pregabalin. Okay, the drugs which are not used are valproate. Valproate is not used. Okay, remember benzodiazepines are not used because of their highly addictive potential. So as you can see, carbamazepine and phenytoin are given. So this is the best option you will go by. Okay, a patient on anticonvulsive tablet took 20 tablets and he developed hyponatremia, raised BP. And hyponatremia with raised BP is a classical feature of ADH, because ADH causes increase in water, which will increase BP, dilutional hyponatremia. And increase in ADH level is seen with carbamazepine. Okay, so the answer out here is carbamazepine. Okay, now neural tube defect is a teratogenic effect which is most commonly seen with valproate. It is also seen with carbamazepine. So you will go by the answer valproate, most commonly by valproate. Which of the following anti-epileptic mechanism of action is wrongly matched? Ethosuximide potassium channel opener, false. Ethosuximide rather blocks calcium channel, T type of calcium channel. Phenytoin sodium channel blocker, true. Diazepam increased GABA, true. Gabapentin increased release of GABA, true. Okay, so the incorrect answer is ethosuximide. Drug of choice for absence seizure is ethosuximide, followed by valproate. Not given, followed by lamotrigine. This is the order of preference. Now there is lot of controversy. Go by the word ethosuximide. It is the safest drug we have. Weight gain is not seen with. Remember, weight gain, if you will see the list of the anti-epileptic drug which will cause weight loss, are topiramate. Topiramate is combined with phentermine, which is a sympathetic drug, and this combination is given for approved as an anti-obesity weight loss drug. Zonisamide, it is combined with bupropion and felbamate. The weight gain is seen with phenytoin, valproate, pregabalin, and gabapentin. So left side, the drugs causes weight loss. So as you can see that carbamazepine gain. Chlorpromazine is a tricyclic antidepressant. You are seeing phentermine, right, Hitan? This phentermine, remember, is combined with topiramate, and this combination is an approved as an anti-obesity drug, phentermine. It's a sympathetic drug. Renal stone, remember, is a side effect of two anti-epileptic drugs, topiramate and zonisamide. These two anti-epileptic drugs, remember, they cause renal stone. The reason is because they have carbonic anhydrase inhibiting property. Because of carbonic anhydrase inhibiting property, they cause loss of calcium oxalate in urine. Hence, they cause calcium oxalate stone in urine. So the answer out here you are seeing is zonisamide. So the two anti-epileptic drug which causes renal stones are topiramate and zonisamide because of their carbonic anhydrase inhibiting property. Now, lamotrigine has the most common side effect. It causes skin rashes, which can lead to Stevens-Johnson syndrome. This is the most common side effect. Go by the word rashes. That is why it is contraindicated in small children because of severe rash. Drug of choice for a patient with combined primary GTCS and absence seizure. Now, GTCS is due to sodium channel. Absence seizure is due to calcium channel. The drug which can act on both sodium and calcium channel is valproate and lamotrigine. Okay, so the answer you will find out here will be valproate. Carbamazepine has drug interaction with all of the following except. Now remember, carbamazepine is an enzyme inducer. It's an enzyme inducer. And remember, it increases the metabolism of various CYP enzyme. It increases the activity of CYP. Now remember erythromycin. Erythromycin gets metabolized by CYP3A4. Phenytoin gets metabolized by CYP2C9. For complete concept, you have to see the video. Barbiturate is also metabolized by CYP3A4. Doxycycline is not metabolized by CYP, hence the answer is doxycycline. Drug of choice to control convulsion in pregnancy is magnesium sulfate, which is also known as drug of choice for eclampsia, seizures during pregnancy. Vigabatrin is, remember, it increases GABA degradation, hence it decreases GABA degradation. Hence, it increases the level of GABA. Hence, it will promote the action of GABA. So, you will go by the answer GABA agonism. Agonism means promoting the action. Fosphenytoin is different from phenytoin. Remember, phenytoin is given orally. Fosphenytoin is IV. Why? Because it is more water soluble. It can be given as an injection into the blood at faster speed. That is why it is given in emergency known as status epilepticus. Okay. So, fosphenytoin is different from phenytoin. In which of the following aspect? The aspect is fosphenytoin cannot be given orally, while phenytoin can be given orally. Fos means water soluble. Faster. Drug of choice for infantile spasm with tuberous sclerosis. Remember, the drug of choice for infantile spasm is ACTH with glucocorticoid. But if you want to see that if it is associated with tuberous sclerosis also, then the answer is vigabatrin. Okay. So if they are occurring both of them together, then the answer is vigabatrin. So go by the answer vigabatrin. Valproic causes all of the following. Enzyme induction, false. Remember, it is the only anti-epileptic drug which is an enzyme inhibitor. Rest, all other anti-epileptic drug are enzyme inducer. It causes obesity, true. Weight gain, hepatotoxic, very dangerous side effect. It is the most common, most teratogenic effect which causes neural tube defect. So the answer is enzyme induction. No, it is rather an enzyme inhibitor. Regarding phenytoin, which of the following statements are true except it act on voltage sensitive sodium channel? True. Yes, it acts on sodium channel. It is given by slow IV injection? True. The drug which can be given fast IV injection in status epilepticus is the water soluble form of phenytoin, that is fosphenytoin. It can be given faster. Phenytoin is given slower. Kinetic changes from first to zero order over therapeutic range? The answer is true. If you little bit increase the dose, the saturation kinetics occurs. It inhibits microsomal enzyme. Now, this is a false statement. Remember, all anti-epileptic drugs except valproate are enzyme inducer. They induce microsomal enzyme except valproate. So, phenytoin, carbamazepine, phenobarbital, they all are enzyme inducer. Not true about fosphenytoin. Remember, fosphenytoin is given. Not true about fosphenytoin. It is given for GTCS, true, in cases of status epilepticus. Okay. It's a prodrug of phenytoin. Yes. In the body, it gets converted into phenytoin. It is lipid soluble, false. Remember, it is rather water soluble form. Okay. It is highly plasma protein bound, true. It is bind just like albumin. Just like phenytoin, it is bound to albumin. So it is more of a water soluble. All of the following are the side effects of valproic acid except it causes alopecia, true, hepatitis, true, skin rashes, true. Remember, it is not nephrotoxic. It is not nephrotoxic. Okay. So anti-epileptic drugs overall are not nephrotoxic drug. They are generally hepatotoxic drugs. Now, a 20-year-old female with GTCS, generalized tonic-clonic seizures, is well controlled on phenytoin, became pregnant. Pick the correct statement. Remember, the treatment of epilepsy in pregnancy is continue with old anti-epileptic drug. So, strophenytoin, no. Strophenytoin, false. Strophenytoin, false. Continue with phenytoin, yes. And add folic acid in the, and in the last 2 weeks, add vitamin K2. So, this is the true statement. So, I've already told you the treatment of epilepsy in pregnancy. So, the answer is D. Okay. So, D is the correct answer. Administration of which anti-epileptic drug is associated with development of hyperkinesia in children? That is phenobarbital. Phenobarbital causes hyperkinesia in children. A 22-year-old anti-epileptic therapy female got married. What should the folic acid supplementation should be advised? Remember, the folic acid should be given to all women who can become pregnant. To all women who can become pregnant. Okay. Anticonvulsant with visual field contraction. I have already told you VI means visual field effect, vigabactrin. Okay. Vigabactrin. And the last question of epilepsy is, a 26-year-old female present with a history of abortion in the last pregnancy due to neural tube defect. What is the amount of folic acid? I have already told you normally we give folic acid. That is 400 microgram. But if the female has a history of neural tube defect and abortion, and if the female is on valproate, give 10 times dose of folic acid, that is 4000 micrograms in these two cases. History of previous neural tube defect, or if the female is on valproate, give 4000 microgram, which is equivalent to 4 milligrams. Okay. So the answer out here is 4000 micrograms per day. That is 4000 micrograms per day. Now let's talk about the treatment of neurodegenerative disease. Now we will discuss about various neurodegenerative disease like Parkinson's disease, Wilson's disease, Huntington's disease, Alzheimer's disease, ALS, that is amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, and lastly multiple sclerosis. Okay, so let's see that first the treatment of Parkinson's disease. Now, what is Parkinson's disease? It's an idiopathic condition. There is a probable toxin known as MPTP toxin, which degenerates dopaminergic neuron in substantia nigra pars compacta of basal ganglia. Dopamine reduces muscle tone. Due to lack of dopamine, the muscle tone increases. So the patient have less movement, bradykinesia, rigidity, fascinating gait, and due to relative increase in acetylcholine level, there is resting tremors. Now, how dopamine is released from substantia nigra neuron? Dopamine normally gets synthesized from DOPA, and it enters into the vesicle and it is released, and it is degraded by MAO-B and COMT enzyme. And in basal ganglia, we have two receptors, D1 and D2 receptor. Now, let's see what are the drug. The first drug we have, which can cross blood-brain barrier and enter into the brain and gets converted into dopamine, that is levodopa. Then we have a drug which inhibits MAO-B and COMT degradation of dopamine, MAO-B inhibitor and COMT inhibitor. Then we have a drug which act as a dopamine agonist, directly act on receptors and stimulate those receptors. So this is the complete list of the drugs of Parkinson's disease. Dopamine prodrug, levodopa. Peripheral DOPA decarboxylase inhibitor, which inhibit the peripheral conversion of levodopa into dopamine, carbidopa, benzerazide. Selective MAO-B inhibitor, irreversible selegiline, rasageline, reversible safinamide. COMT inhibitor, both in brain and periphery, tolcapone, only peripherally, entacapone, opicapone and niticapone. Dopamine agonist, ergot, bromocriptine, cabergoline and pergolide. Non-ergot, ropinrol, pramipexol, rotigotin, which are oral. Apomorphine, which is injectable. Amantadine, which is an NMDA antagonist, also an anticholinergic and dopamine releaser. Now, what is the treatment of Parkinson's disease? If a person is having no functional impairment, give rasageline selective MAO-B inhibitor. Because it is the only anti-Parkinson drug we have, which can protect neurons, neuroprotective effect. But if the patient is having functional disability, we give levodopa. Levodopa is the most effective drug for Parkinson's disease. Most effective. In mild cases, you can give dopamine agonist, ropinrol, pramipexol. But levodopa has certain problem. Levodopa can be converted into dopamine in periphery, which can produce side effect. Hence, we inhibit peripheral degradation by giving carbidopa, benzerazide. With time, the effect of levodopa reduces, because there are no neurons which can convert levodopa into dopamine. Because of this reason, the effect of levodopa reduces in long term, which is known as on-off phenomena. So on means when you will give levodopa, it will produce effect, and suddenly the effect of levodopa will be lost, which is known as off phenomena. Now, to prolong on phenomena, we inhibit the degradation of dopamine by giving COMT inhibitor and MAO-B inhibitor. And to rescue from rigid posture or rescue position, we give injections of apomorphine. Now, levodopa produces dyskinesia. To control dyskinesia or excessive movement, we give amantadine. Levodopa cannot reduce one symptom of Parkinson's disease, that is resting tremor or severe tremor. For that, we give anticholinergic drug benzoxol. So this is the treatment of Parkinson's disease in one page. So let's talk about levodopa. Why we give levodopa, not dopamine? Because levodopa can cross blood-brain barrier. It's a prodrug in brain. It gets converted into dopamine by dopa decarboxylase enzyme, which is a vitamin B6 dependent enzyme. Okay, but when we give levodopa, it can be converted into dopamine in periphery also. So that is why levodopa is combined with peripheral dopa decarboxylase inhibitor, carbidopa and vencerazide. But remember, levodopa should never be combined with vitamin B6. Vitamin B6 increases peripheral degradation of levodopa. Now, what are the side effects of levodopa in central nervous in CNS, which cannot be reduced by carbidopa? In basal ganglia, it can cause excessive movement, which is known as dyskinesia. The drug of choice for levodopa-induced dyskinesia is amantadine. In cortical portion, it can cause psychosis. The drug of choice for levodopa-induced psychosis is clozapine. A new drug is pimavanserin. In medullary area, it can produce hypersexuality and impulsive gambling. Now, the peripheral side effects which can be reduced by carbidopa are: it acts on CTZ area, nausea and vomiting are the most common side effect. Hence, we block dopamine receptor by giving domperidone, which is the drug of choice. By acting on D1 receptor, it produces vasodilatation and hypotension. Remember, it is hypotension, not hypertension. Beta-1, it can produce cardiac arrhythmia. Alpha-1, midriasis. And remember, any midriatic is contraindicated in narrow-angle glaucoma. There are three contraindications of levodopa: narrow-angle glaucoma, melanoma, because dopa can form melanin pigment, and peptic ulcers. Now, D2 receptor agonists are ergots and non-ergots. Bromocriptine, cabergoline, and pergolide, they are not used nowadays because they cause ergotism. In ergotism, there is dry gangrene of limb, pain in limbs, erythromelalgia, cardiac valvular and retroperitoneal fibrosis. They may also cause Raynaud's disease. Hence, now we give non-ergot. Now, non-ergots are of three types: oral, ropinirole and pramipexole. Okay, they are also the drug of choice for restless leg syndrome. We can give transcranial patch of roticotin, apomorphine. Apomorphine is the drug of choice from rescue from off position. Okay. Now let's talk about Wilson disease. Wilson disease is a disease in which Parkinson's disease occurs in very low ages. It's an autosomal recessive condition. The level of ceruloplasmin, which is a copper chelator, is reduced. So the free copper level in the blood increases, and this free copper can deposit in various organs. The liver will get damaged. It can lead to cirrhosis. In brain, it can lead to Parkinson's. In cornea, it can lead to Kieser-Fleischer rings. Now what is the treatment? The main treatment is zinc. Zinc inhibits the absorption of copper from GIT. It is the safest drug and it is always given. It is the only drug which is given in children and pregnancy. Now, if there is cirrhosis of liver, we give a copper chelator, trientine, not controlled penicillamine, not controlled do liver transplant. If there is CNS abnormality, give a copper chelator, tetrathiomolybdate. Okay. Then amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, also known as Law-Gehrig's disease. Stephen Hawking, a famous physicist who suffered from this disease, is so it's a neurodegenerative disease. To protect neuron, three drugs are approved, that is riluzole, edaravone and masitinib. To control muscle spasm, we give baclofen, benzodiazepine and tizanidine alpha 2 agonist. And to control other symptoms like drooling of saliva, we give anticholinergic. Pseudobulbar symptom, we give dextromethorphan and quinidine. So try to remember these three drugs: riluzole, edaravone and masitinib, to protect the neuron from degeneration in amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. These three drugs you must remember. Now, multiple sclerosis, it's an autoimmune disease which can damage central nervous system neuron by damaging myelin sheath. It is of three types: relapsing remitting multiple sclerosis, attack will come but the disease will not progress. The drug of choice for long-term treatment is interferon. Secondary progressive multiple sclerosis, after a certain time, the neuronal degeneration increases. The only drug approved is mitoxantron. Primary progressive, which is the most dangerous drug, the only drug approved for the treatment is ocrelizumab. So these are the drugs which we give for long-term treatment. They are immunosuppressive drug. But remember, for acute attack of any of these conditions, the drug of choice is corticosteroid methylprednisolone. And if it is not responsive, remove these antibodies by plasmapheresis. In long-term treatment, we give immunosuppressant. The mnemonic is go find that MD. Glatiramer, ocrelizumab, fingolimode, interferon, natalizumab, daclizumab. For complete description, you have to see the videos. Okay. Now, the Alzheimer's disease. It's the most common feature in Alzheimer's disease is dementia, memory loss, short-term memory loss. Okay. So the drug of choice for dementia in Alzheimer's disease is acetylcholinesterases, which increase the level of acetylcholine in the brain. Drug of choice is donepezil, rivastigmine, and galantamine. Tacrine has been banned. In severe cases, we give memantine, NMDA antagonist. Okay. So try to remember these four drugs in Alzheimer's disease. Okay. For the complete description, these are the various drugs which we give in Alzheimer's disease. So this is about neurodegenerative disease in nutshell. Let's talk about the disease. The drug used for the treatment of Parkinson's disease includes all of the following. Levodopa, the answer is absolutely true. Levodopa is used, it is the drug of choice. Mesendol, false. Remember, mesendol is an antipsychotic drug. Bromocriptine, true. D2 agonist. Acyclovir, false. Remember, acyclovir is a drug for herpes group of virus. Benzerazide. Remember, benzerazide is also not used. Okay. So the treatment is levodopa and bromocriptine. Which of the following drug is used as a transcranial patch? Transcranial patch is given of a D2 agonist drug, that is rotigotin. Okay. Rotigotin, which I have already told you. Okay. Rotigotin is given as a transcranial patch in the treatment of Parkinson's disease. Okay. Now, which of the following drug increases bioavailability of levodopa in patients? With levodopa, remember, we combine carbidopa and benzerazide to inhibit peripheral degradation. But that is a different thing. To increase bioavailability, we inhibit degradation of levodopa in intestine. Now remember, in our intestine, we have COMT enzyme. Hence, we give COMT inhibitor. In our intestine, we have only COMT enzyme. While in our brain, we have both COMT enzyme and MAO-B enzyme, which degrades dopamine. Hence, bioavailability will be increased when we will inhibit the degradation of levodopa in intestine. Hence, we give a COMT inhibitor. The answer is entacapone. Entacapone inhibits COMT-mediated degradation of levodopa in intestine. Okay. Selegiline is MAO-B inhibitor. And MAO-B, remember, it is only present in brain. It will only affect the increase the effect of levodopa in the brain. Okay. So remember this part. Now, all of the following drugs regarding levodopa is correct. In Parkinson's, phenothiazine reduces efficacy. The answer is true. Now, remember, phenothiazines are antipsychotic drug. They block dopamine receptor. And because of this reason, their side effect is they increase the risk of Parkinson's disease. So if you will give levodopa, it will not able to act. Levodopa is a prodrug. It's absolutely true. Its active form we know is of dopamine. Pyridoxine reduces its effect in levodopa, true, because vitamin B6 increases the degradation of levodopa into dopamine in periphery. Domperidone blocks levodopa-induced MSS in CTZ area, true. Remember, this CTZ area, which is the vomiting center, is outside the blood-brain barrier, and its therapeutic or beneficial effect, now this is a false statement. This domperidone, it cannot enter into BBB, blood-brain barrier. Hence, it cannot reduce the effect of levodopa in the basal ganglia. it will only reduce the peripheral effect of levodopa in CTZ area, which is outside the blood-brain barrier. Okay? Which is outside the blood-brain barrier. Now, a patient of Parkinsonism is managed with levodopa. Vitamin B is administered concurrently. Remember, vitamin B increases peripheral degradation or peripheral conversion of levodopa into dopamine. Hence, the peripheral side effect of levodopa will increase. Okay? So, it will be less available to act on the brain. So, the action of levodopa in the brain will potentiate it false. It will rather reduce. Decarboxylation of levodopa in the brain will be reduced false. Side effects will be ameliorated, reduce false. Its efficacy will reduce. The answer is true, because more of dopamine will be converted, levodopa will be converted into dopamine in periphery. Less amount will be available to enter into the brain. Okay. Now, rohypnol is used in the treatment of. Rohypnol is a D2 agonist, which is given orally, and it is given in the treatment of Parkinson's disease, and it is also given in the treatment of restless leg syndrome. Okay, so the answer out here is rohypnol, Parkinsonism. Which of the following statement is false regarding to the drugs used in Parkinsonism? Amantadine causes ankle edema, true. It produces ankle edema, which is also sometimes known as livido reticularis. Although it is a widespread edema, but it causes ankle edema. Levodopa is effective in reducing tremors. The answer is absolutely false. Remember, dopamine increases tremors. So, levodopa cannot reduce the tremors. Sorry, levodopa can reduce all the symptoms of Parkinson, all symptoms of Parkinson except tremors. For tremors, we give anticholinergic drug, that is benzhexazole. So, levodopa cannot reduce only one symptom of Parkinson, that is tremors. Amantadine is more effective than levodopa, again false. Levodopa is the most effective drug. Antimuscarinic drugs are effective in drug-induced Parkinsonism, true. Okay, true. So, remember this part. Drugs causing Parkinsonism include, the drug which causes Parkinsonism, remember, they block dopamine receptor. Okay, now phenothiazine, remember, it blocks dopamine receptor, true. Bromocriptine is a D2 agonist. It is rather given for the treatment of Parkinsonism. Haloperidol, true. Amantadine, false. Carbidopa, false. They are rather used. Remember, the answer is phenothiazine and haloperidol. These two drugs, they block dopamine receptor, and these drugs are known as antipsychotic drug. Okay. Antipsychotic drug, their side effect is Parkinson's disease. Okay, why they block dopamine receptor. And remember, the drugs which are used in Parkinson's disease, like levodopa, which is used in Parkinson's disease, increases dopamine level. Their side effect is psychosis. Their side effect is psychosis. Increase in dopamine causes psychosis. Which of the following drugs should not be given with levodopa? The answer is vitamin B complex, because vitamin B complex will increase peripheral conversion of levodopa into dopamine. Okay. Because of this reason, the peripheral side effects will increase and reduce availability of dopamine will be into the brain. Drug of choice for drug-induced Parkinsonism. Remember, in drug-induced Parkinsonism, levodopa is contraindicated. Levodopa is only given in idiopathic Parkinsonism or neurodegenerative. In drug-induced Parkinsonism, the drug of choice is, you will write, centrally acting anticholinergic drugs. Anticholinergic drugs like benzhexazole, benztropine, biperidine. ओके, सो द आंसर इज बेंजहेक्सॉल. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग अबॉलिशेस और रिड्यूसेस द थेरेप्यूटिक इफेक्ट ऑफ लिवोडोपा. द आंसर इज विटामिन B6 बाय इंक्रीजिंग द पेरिफेरल कन्वर्जन. इन ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ पार्किंसोनिज्म एल-डोपा इज कंबाइंड विद कार्बिडोपा टू प्रिवेंट द पेरिफेरल कन्वर्जन ऑफ डोपामिन इनटू डो इनटू सो टू इंक्रीज द क्रॉसिंग ऑफ लिवोडोपा बाय इनटू द ब्लड ब्रेन बैरियर. बिकॉज कार्बिडोपा विल रिड्यूस पेरिफेरल कन्वर्जन इनटू डोपामिन. So because of this reason, this L-DOPA is more available to enter into brain. Okay. Anti-Parkinsonism drug that is selective COMT inhibitor. COMT inhibitor is, they will end with the word capon. So the answer out here is entacapon. True statement about the drug used in Parkinsonism is, amantadine is a cholinergic drug. False. Remember, it is rather an anticholinergic drug. Okay. Vitamin B6 enhances the effect of levodopa. False. It rather reduces the effect of levodopa. COMT inhibitors prolong the action of L-DOPA. True, because they increase bioavailability in intestine. None of the above. No. So the answer is C. A 72-year-old patient with Parkinsonism presents with swollen feet, red, tender and very painful. You can clear up this symptom. Clear up means that if you will press, the symptoms will clear. This is a classical case of livido reticularis. Livido means they are reddish or purplish color, and if you will press them, it will vanish, it will remove. So, libido reticularis is a classical side effect of amantadine. Okay. Evanescent lesions are seen. All of the following are the side effect of ropinirole. Except. Now, ropinirole is D2 agonist. And D2 agonist, remember dopamine, it acts on CTZ area. It causes nausea and vomiting. Okay. Nausea and vomiting. Second, it acts in cortex. It may cause hallucination. Third, it may cause sedation or somnolence. Somnolence means excessive sleep. Okay? Excessive sleep. Now the point is, it will not cause retroperitoneal fibrosis. Now, ropinirole, remember, is a non-ergot derivative. It is a non-ergot D2 agonist. Retroperitoneal fibrosis is a side effect of ergot D2 agonist. So, ergot derivatives, remember, they cause fibrosis of retroperitoneal fibrosis or cardiac valvular fibrosis. Ropinirole is a non-ergot derivative. It will not cause. Okay? Now, anti-Parkinsonism drugs cause cardiac valvular fibrosis was ergot. And that is why one drug got banned. That drug was pergolide. Okay, pergolide. All are dopaminergic agonists used in Parkinsonism. So, I'll show you the slide of dopaminergic agonist drugs so that you will have an idea again. So, dopamine agonist, ergots and non-ergot. Ergot are bromocriptine, cabergoline and pergolide. They cause retroperitoneal fibrosis and cardiac valvular fibrosis. Non-ergots are propranolol, pramipexol, rotigotin and apomorphine. They cause somnolence, etc. And same side effect like dopamine. So, which of the following drugs are dopaminergic agonists used in Parkinsonism except bromocriptine? True. Ropinirole? True. Pramipexol? True. So the false statement is seligiline. If a drug is selling with the word giline, remember it is a MAO-B inhibitor. Okay. Which of the following drug has a potential to cause retroperitoneal fibrosis, that is ergot? And which drug you remember from ergot is bromocriptine. Bromocriptine is an ergot. Now, drug of choice for relapsing remitting multiple sclerosis is interferon beta. Interferon beta is the drug of choice for relapsing remitting multiple sclerosis. Okay. The drug of choice for secondary progressive multiple sclerosis is mitoxantrone. And the drug of choice for primary progressive multiple sclerosis is ocrelizumab. The drug of choice for acute attack of any type of multiple sclerosis is intravenous methylprednisolone. Okay. Now, where interferon alpha is used, remember interferon alpha is given in hepatitis B virus and hepatitis C virus infection. Okay. It is also given in hepatitis human papilloma virus infection also. Okay. Human papilloma virus. Now, interferon gamma, remember it is given in chronic granulomatous disease. It is given in chronic granulomatous disease. Okay. So, try to remember. So, in multiple sclerosis, we give beta. Multiple sclerosis, we give interferon beta. Which of the following only drug is effective in improving EDSS scale in multiple sclerosis? Now, EDSS scale, remember, is known as extended disability status scale. Now, if a drug reduces, improves extended disability status scale, it can decrease progression of a disease. It can decrease progression of a disease in multiple sclerosis. Now, can you tell me which two drugs can reduce the progression of disease? So, there are two types of multiple sclerosis, that is secondary progressive and primary progressive. So, you can see that mitoxantrone and ocrelizumab can reduce progression of the disease. And if they can reduce the progression of disease, they can reduce, improve EDSS scale, that is extended disability status scale. So the answer out here, you are not finding out here is mitoxantrone. That is the best answer. Remember, if mitoxantrone is not given, then you will go by the answer that is natalizumab. But now the best answer is mitoxantrone. So if it is not given, then you will go by the answer natalizumab. So it's an old question. So now the option has correct answer have become mitoxantrone and ocrelizumab. Which of the following drug is not used in multiple sclerosis? The drug which is not given in multiple sclerosis is mycophenolate mofetil. Okay. It is rather an immunosuppressive drug. It is given in organ transplant. Okay. Interferon betas are given. Glatiramer acetate is given. So this is the complete list of drugs, that is go find that is glatiramer acetate, ocrelizumab, interferon beta, it is also given. And you can see in this list, mycophenolate mofetil is not written. Which of the following is combined with rivastigmine decreases its efficacy? Now remember, what is rivastigmine? Rivastigmine is anticholine esterase. Anticholine esterase means it will increase the level of acetylcholine, and it is used in the treatment of Alzheimer's disease because acetylcholine increases memory. In Alzheimer's disease, there is memory loss. Now, which of the following drug can decrease the effect of, which can decrease the effect of rivastigmine? The answer out here is tricyclic antidepressant. Tricyclic antidepressant, remember, they block. It is the only antidepressant which can block acetylcholine receptors. Which can block acetylcholine receptors. Okay. So, answer out here is this. So, if a patient of Alzheimer's disease comes with depression, don't give tricyclic antidepressant, rather give SSRI. Okay. So, I'll show you that slide of slide for depression in Alzheimer's disease, give SSRI, don't give TCA, tricyclic antidepressants. Okay. So, which of the following about trientine? Remember, trientine is a copper chelator and it is given in the treatment of Wilson's disease. Okay. It is given in the treatment of Wilson. It is more potent than penicillamine. It is absolutely true, and it is more safer. It is given as an alternative to penicillamine. True. Okay. It should not be given within 2 hours of iron administration. The answer is true. It can cause iron deficiency anemia, which is reversed by oral iron supplementation. Now, this is a false statement. Okay. It is a copper chelator. It generally causes copper deficiency anemia. Which of the following drugs is used in Alzheimer's disease? So, in Alzheimer's disease, donepezil is used. True. Pimolin, false. Doxapram is an pimolin, remember, is an amphetamine. Doxapram is an analeptic. It is respiratory stimulant. Methylphenidate is also an amphetamine. So, the drug of choice is donepezil. It is an anticholinesterase drug. Which of the following is nootropic? Nootropic means that will increase memory. And the drug is piracetam. That is why it is approved in Alzheimer's disease, to increase memory. Mechanism of action of donepezil. Remember, donepezil is centrally acting reversible anticholinesterase. It's a carbamate. So, because of this reason, it will increase the level of acetylcholine. Remember, reversible. Irreversible inhibitors are never given. Drugs beneficial in amyotrophic lateral sclerosis. I have already told you, riluzole, neuroprotective drug. The other new drugs are edaravone and masitinib. Okay. Now, peripheral vasospasm is caused by ergots. Okay. So, try to find an ergot, and that is bromocriptine. Hence, they produce a side effect known as Raynaud's disease. Or they can cause erythromelalgia. Or they can cause dry gangrene of limbs, because they act on serotonin receptor, which may produce. Now, which of the following drug is not used in Alzheimer? Memantine used, true. Galantamine used, donepezil used. The answer is ropinrol. Remember, ropinrol is rather used in Parkinson's disease. Ropinrol is given in Parkinson's disease. Okay. So, this is all about neurodegenerative disease and epilepsy. So, thank you very much.